Okay, it's Jim Fisher again with the Wild World of Wildlife. It's still the 29th of September. It's getting to be about 20 to 6, and I'm trying to walk out of the woods now. This is when the snakes really do come out, but there's also it's hunting season, so I'd like to get out before. I don't think there's any hunters hunting in this swamp, but just for my own safety. And I think I've come across another Agkistrodon piscivorus, and I don't know if I'll be able to catch him or not, or her or not. Excuse me. I need somebody to fund me for my film documentaries. Sponsor me so that I can. I'll take Animal Planet, Discovery, you know, I'll go anywhere you want me to. Animal Planet, Discovery, what is the other channel, National Geographic. I think I've seen another. Yeah, there he is. And he can already sense me because he can feel my vibrations. And he is on land. She is on land, and she, or he, is a big one. She or he is a big one, and I may be able to get this one. Now let's see how they act. This is a huge, look at them whipping a tail, like a rattlesnake. Like, I'm gonna try and fake you out. I'm gonna think you, I'm a rattlesnake. Oh, pit vipers. I can feel the heat, sense the heat. It's all coiled up, trying to stay warm, getting ready to hunt for tonight. Huge head. Not really a huge, not as big as I've seen. But see the thickness of the body and how pretty it just lays there. I'm going to kind of look around just to make sure that there's not another one around. So I'm looking around while I've got hopefully the camera focused on this. And see if he's going to stand his ground. Most of the time they take off and run. Oh, he just flipped over, didn't he? Oh, look at him showing them fangs. Look at him showing them fangs. Oh, let's see if we can get a close up of that. Oh man, look at that. Ah. I hope the camera's getting that. Can you see down my throat? You see that hole? Maybe he'll open that hole again. When he's swallowing his food, there it is. See when he opens that hole? When he swallows his food, he can still breathe through that so he doesn't suffocate. And this guy is huge. He's flattening himself out, as you can tell, to make himself even look even bigger. But he is a big one. He is a big one. Or she. Sorry there, girls. I haven't checked underneath yet, so I don't know. But it definitely doesn't like me. And he's standing his ground, this one is. This one's big enough to stand its ground. It's not on a log. It's not anywhere it can escape to. It's just looking at me, staring at me. Oh, what a beautiful snake we be. Show that cottonmouth. That's why. And the reason why their hemotoxin is so much more poisonous than a copperhead or a pilot or what they call a highland moccasin. We call them copperheads. These will actually eat. Rat snakes, and they'll eat copperheads. Copperheads den with rat snakes and other snakes, rattlesnakes, timber rattlers, other poisonous snakes, but they won't den with these guys. These guys will eat them. And usually the reason why they call the copperhead a pilot snake is because they pilot their way. They pilot their way around. They pilot their way around to the den, wherever the den's going to be.